In this video, I will show how to modify the controller in order to be charged with the standard micro USB adapter. And I used a vintage phone battery to double the battery life. Then I will show why you need a PS3 connected or a laptop in order to charge it. Let's get started. The original battery is a 570 mAh with a maximum charge current of 700 mA. If you attach the controller to the laptop, it will start charging because of an USB handshaking.
This is the data minus of the device while charging. And here you can see the waveforms.
The logic level high of one signal is higher than the other one, so I guess one is the host, the other one is the controller. That's why you cannot use a standard USB charger, not even if you put a pull down on the data minus cable. Before we replace the battery, let's see how the original charger works. So the maximum charge voltage for these chargers is 4.2 volts, so this is a standard lithium charger. And the original charge current is 360 mA.
At this point, I see two possibilities. Hack the PCB in order to enable the charger, even without the handshaking, or to use an external charger. This is also providing higher current and the micro USB, because I don't like the mini USB on the controller. Since the current is higher, you will need also a bigger battery, because otherwise you may exceed the current level for the original battery, which is 700 mA. All you need is two wiring. 1 euro USB charger, an old battery 1 amp or above.
Let's get started. Solder two wires directly on the battery connector. Be careful at the polarity. Drill two holes on the cover in order to make the wire of the new charger passing. Cut the cable at the right length and pass it through the holes in the cover. Solder the charger PCB. Be careful to solder it at the battery terminal and not somewhere else. Prepare the new battery, cutting the cables from the old one. Solder the connector wires to the new battery, paying attention to the polarity. Connect the battery to the battery connector. Now you can close the controller and give it a quick test. If the controller powers on and the charger is able to charge the battery, you can glue the charger into the controller case, but I suggest you to scratch it with some sandpaper before. Check also how much is the voltage during charge. It should be within 1% of 4.2 volts, and then it should stop charge with a blue light. Now, protect all the components by applying some glue. I used the Gorilla Glue.
The controller is still very ergonomic because it's completely out of the reach of your fingers. Have fun, enjoy it. Please recall, do not use the standard battery with this charger or this may explode. Use only protected battery so the controller, if left on, will not over discharge it. Stay safe, have fun.